Now in section 3.2.3, we will discuss the force in energy. Like we are having two configurations. One, this configuration means a single charge and a conducting grounded sheet, and two opposite charges at 2D distance apart from each other. We came to the result that the induced charge is exactly equal to minus Q, which is on the sheet. So now we calculate the force between these two charges, and the force, as we know from the Coulomb's law, is 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 over R squared. And we know that Q1 is 4 pi epsilon naught, and Q1 is Q, and Q2 is minus Q. So the force comes out to be minus Q squared divided by R, is basically equal to 2D here. R equals 2D. The distance between the two charges is 2D, and it will come out to be 4D squared. And if I write this in a vectorial form, then it is along the z-axis. So this is along the z-axis, this is along the r unit vector direction, and now in this case the r unit vector direction is basically the z unit vector direction. So it follows that the two things are the same. Like if we consider a single charge and then a sheet which is grounded and conducting, and two opposite charges at some distance apart from each other, so both the things are equivalent to each other in all aspects. But it is not like this, because look here, where is the problem? The problem is here, that when I am bringing this charge, means this charge, from infinity toward this conducting sheet, then I am doing work on only one charge. And when I am bringing this Q charge from infinity into the presence of minus Q charge, then I am doing work on both of the charges. Means the work is basically done on both of the charges. Here I am not doing any work on the sheet, because the sheet is at ground potential. So it means that here single work is done and here double work is done. So the energy of the two system will differentiate this thing. That basically these two geometries are not equivalent in all aspects. And let us calculate this thing, whether we are right or not. So if I consider two charges, means this geometry, and there is no conductor, then in the second chapter we have derived already that work done is half and qi summation on I and V of Ri, and this thing we calculated there, that this work comes out to be minus 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught minus 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught and Q square over 2D. And now we do calculate this work for this geometry. And this geometry work is, we haven't calculated that one. This we calculated in the second chapter. And I have provided the link which will give you easy access to that video in which we have calculated this thing. So here, let's say the work the work is equal to, we are bringing from infinity to d, because it's d distance apart from the sheet, so we are bringing it from infinity to d, and the work done, we are writing dl. Now this thing is equal, the force we have already with us, this is minus 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught, and this is q square over 4d square, so the integral, and q square over 4d square and z unit vector dot, while the dl is basically the dz in z unit vector. So this thing, I will have to replace this thing with here, this d I will have to replace with z, because here we are having integration on dz, so this will be z and like that. So here we are with q square over minus q square over 16 and pi epsilon naught integral from infinity to d, okay, infinity to d, and z unit vector goes with z unit vector, and this one we are having 1 over z square dz, and we will do integrate this thing. Now the z square integration, I know that it is equal to this thing, so let me write 1 over z square, its integration will come out to be minus 1 over z, so this thing is equal to w equal to 1 over 16 r minus q square over 16 pi epsilon naught, and 1 over z minus, I have written here, so this is 1 over z, and from infinity to 0 to d, so this is equal to minus q square over 16 pi epsilon naught, and this thing is 1 over d minus 1 over infinity, and 1 over infinity goes to 0, so we are having this thing equal, this implies that the work done, I will now write, means this I have written is for 16, so I will be comparing with this one, so I will have to split this thing, and this is minus 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught and q square over 4d. Now this is now clearly visible that here this work is half of that work. So on two charges q and q minus, I'm doing double work here, while here I'm doing half of the work. So it means the two geometries are not exactly the same in terms of energy, because then it would be very easy that we are having one charge and we can get the same energy from such a system, then why to have another charge? So when things comes into energy calculation, then they differentiate from each other, that the two geometries are basically different. And the main reason for this thing is that we are having, when we are bringing a single charge toward the grounded conducting sheet, we are doing work on one charge, while when minus Q is here, mean the presence of it is here, and we are bringing charge Q into the vicinity of this charge, then we are doing work on two charges, not a single charge which we are bringing. And that's differentiate, that the two geometries are basically not equivalent to each other in terms of the law of conservation of energy or the energy conservation. Now let me discuss example 3.2 in light of the method of images. This example is saying that a point charge Q is situated a distance A from the center of a grounded conducting sphere of radius R, which is shown in this figure. Find the potential outside the sphere. Now, if I look at this problem or this example, then this example, two things have been written here in the solution of this. I am not discussing the geometry, but the solution or the direct result which is written here, Q prime is equal to minus R over A in Q, while B is equal, the two terminologies here, B is equal to R square over A. Now the big question arises, from where we get these results? So this example has not been solved exactly in your book, but I have solved this example in the classical electrodynamics. So I'm not repeating this one, but if you are interested to find the solution of this example, then I have provided you a link to the classical electrodynamics lecture, which is based on J.D. Jackson. If you are interested, you can go there and you can see that how the Q prime, the image charge, comes out to be equal to R over A times the source charge, and how the B distance comes out to be equal to R square over A. So these things you can see over there. I think it's beyond the scope here, because if it would have been solved here, then I would have gone for it. Otherwise, I have solved it over there. And if you are having the interest to find the solution, you can go there and find the solution of this thing in more detail.